contact through your Zoom then of the business. They have to take all reasonable steps to do so. However, we have need to be very cautious in those circumstances because there can be some situations where the existing license holder doesn't want to transfer it. So we have had some quite detailed investigations into the history sometimes of when somebody wants to take those premises licenses. And as you know, we do work very closely with the police. But yes, if, unless it's surrendered or it dies as a result of the going out of business, then it will still be.
Can I just want a little bit more to it? This one brought me a year or two back. A premises in Warwick was actually changing its name and were applying for an extension of hours. When the paperwork went outside the shop or the one bar, it was a piece of paper that big. And the initial wording was, which is on the top, people who lived close to it didn't recognise it as the British. On the licensing, it's classed under the name. That's the only reason I'm asking this question. But that's very popular.
It's interesting enough whether it's a British Legion as a tenant. But interestingly, under the Licensing Act, there's absolutely no process for somebody to notify us of change of name on the premises. We certainly see how to be asking to do so, but there's not under the licensing. Actually, gives any responsibility about the name, and it can change many times. But obviously, as part of our work, we are visiting premises and see that it's changed the name. We ask them to do that. There's no recognised process.
No recognised process for when we see all the different workshop down, right? We don't have a license. There's no way about it.
Thanks. If you don't mind, I'd like to start with the joke.
I've
then got technical details about a certain solicitor. I'm the licensing manager. 4.7 on page 4 of the draft guidance, line 3, after in accordance with statutory guidance. In accordance with the statutory guidance, as indicated previously by the licensing manager, can I put in people? Oh, sorry, Bill.
What?
Can I put in people?
Please.
Yeah. That was the joke, right? The rest of it is. The rest of it's very tedious and technical. Therefore, not interested. And this is through you, Chair, to our solicitor. 4.14. Is the technical legal terms going to set the licensing authority expect off licenses you have particular diligence? Is it due diligence or is it just diligence? The last sentence of 4.20, cancel the word in contact with the police and addressing crime and disorder issue. Is it the crime and disorder issue as in the license and objectives, or crime and disorder issues as in core?
Issues as in
core. Thank you. 4.29, public nuisance. Dear to all our hearts, in considering the permission of licensing and that applicants and license holders?
No.
Okay, back. condemned. I'm just wondering whether it's at the discretion of the individual licensing board or board of ed organizer, because it might be a better event. Yeah. Four four nine bullet point one, second line. The message document refers to the licensing service or the licensing authority in the same unit.
Yes, and that utility reflects different role in this respect. So I think it probably the consistency in terms of licensing service.
It's just a little picked up because it was like 5.6. Measures proposed in the operator schedule would normally be referred to the condition to be attached to premises license and or put premises certificate. And because of that, can be attached to the premises certificate. 7.8 is the next one. And then count from the bottom, which is the third one, or seven from the top.
So, it is a public meeting,
and we are asked to approve this draft, so that is what I'm doing is I've read it, and therefore I'm detailing to what was it, certain things that I would like to bring into their attention. So I think the second point down on the third one, often and often shouldn't be happening. Confiscation of alcohol from adults and children in designated areas. Children are automatically confiscated alcohol beverages. Designated areas, I understand, is what children can know about alcohol beverages. So therefore, that bullet point is slightly incongruous. It's saying basically, children in designated areas can have their alcohol confiscated.
So just to have a see where I'm coming from.
I'll give you that bit of the chair.
Thank you.
So help that is, have you got no more?
Sorry. Perhaps my planning colleagues who remember this. 13.5 refers to the meeting, but I'm not sure that I'm not a member of planning, whether it should be the other way around.
I'm not sure about that.
So that was a question. That's all the members can help with that.
That came from a contribution from the senior panelists.
And then the very, very final one, Chair, is appendix to second page. This is very interesting. The Cumulative, it says, notify fire office and rescue service head shortly, which obviously is really fun. But use a little bit of box on it. Thank you very much. Any other questions? No. We move that we recommend it. Okay, thank you. And the next one, and the last item, Marcus?
Yes, Chair, and it's really for noting in terms of there was a meeting on the 27th of January, I was invited to the Regeneration Environment and Policy Forum.
Thank you very much.